グリザイアに爆炎
さあ、
Generally speaking, we shouldn't expect too much from a rental car. It's a temporary means of transportation. Nothing wrong. Most places are going to bother needing a flashy sports car or anything. And given the greater cost of insuring more expensive vehicle, you naturally pay more for higher performance ride. Also, you're walking around a sleepy dealership next to the highway that clearly might sell local land down the second side as a tax shelter for you there. There's really no point even hoping for something decent. And when I look over the various cars lined out in the lot, it was all she could do to keep from drowning in dismay. Everywhere she turned, she saw ancient hatchback and coupe for between from 20 or 30 years ago, and they were poorly beaten, invisible, poor condition.
贅沢は言ってられないのは分かってるけどさ。
Yes, fly me to the moon. Shaking her head, she turned toward the brave heart that served as the dealer building, intending to ask if there were any functional cars they could drive off immediately. The low employee inside appeared to be in the middle of a phone call.
はい、ちょうどお見えになられました。
After glancing briefly through the window at her face, the woman put down the phone and said, You are Suamane, correct?
お車の代金はすでにいただいておりますので、どれでもお好きな車をお選びください。
Wait, what?
はい？え？どういうこと？
この状況でレンタカーに目をつけるのは、タナトスさんに予想されてたってこと？
予想というか、車を借りなきゃクリアできない条件を出したのはタナトスさんなんだし、最初からそう仕組まれてるって感じでしょうか。
なるほどね。タナトスさんらしいというか、なんというか。つうかさ、好きなの選べってのはありがたいんだけど。
None of these old cars were particularly appealing, to be honest. They had plenty of mini trucks, many Mazda motor cars, and Suzuki Gai garages. A number of sedans included a four-handtop Nissan Gloria and a Lada HD 2000 SGX, and a row of hatchbacks such as Mazda Familiar XGX and non-turbo Honda City models.Dude, you try to not get copyrighted, right? By using this kind of language. In other words, there was a single car packing the sort of power they required.
唯一スポーツカーっぽいのは、パルサーのミラの X1 か。せめて GTIR だったらな。
You could technically call the XI her hot hatch, but this XIE variant had a non-turbo OHC60 valve 1500cc engine, meaning it was basically a car for old ladies. Still, they have 97 horsepower, although there wasn't anything specially. Especially given the car size, nothing else in this junkyard could really compare. But just as she was about to reluctantly select the X1, Amani sensed something slightly out of the place at her side. The source of this feeling seems to be a Toyota Duet sitting next to the bullseye in the hatchback corner.
このデュエット、もしかして…
Could it be a Daihatsu Notoria? She hadn't noticed at first because it was painted dark green, but it looked a bit like…
Crossfire…
My flat tongue loses behind the tires, she could see a roll cage inside a passenger compartment. The back seat had been removed entirely. Trying to slow her racing heart, I went to circle behind the car and on its rear end, found the X4 logo, along with the TRS sticker of a Daihatsu Racing Service.To think I find you in a place like this. It felt something like running into a dear old friend at the train station. Almost as if it had been waiting for there for years just for her. Overwhelmed by shock and joy, I embraced the car with tears in her eyes.
これ!この子にする!これ貸して!
Irritated by the trembling of her own hands, she hurriedly filled out the rental paperwork. By the time the woman returned her license and handed the keys, she managed to calm down at least a little.Daihatsu Notoria X4. To be certain, its endearing round face and cheap mini car style instantly made it a very old picture of an old lady vehicle. But this unassuming appearance barely is true identity. A genuine sports car boosting a 120 horsepower twin turbo high boost engine and an overall weight of only 840 kilograms. in accordance with the regulations of already racing cars, its engine displacement can aim at a rather unusual 713cc. When an obsessive focus on keeping the car light, even the air conditioner and the audio system were optional, meant it had more than enough power. It was, in short, a micro monster ideally suited to zipping along mountain roads with lots of tight corners. And its blending, moving and steady appeal to its fans, who often cover the seat in white lace to play up the wolf in sheep's clothes angle.
エンジンルームの排熱が悪いのかな。水温の上がりが早い。
When she pressed down on the accelerator to see what would happen, the RPM rose on only sluggishly, suggesting the engine turbines were ridiculously large. The numbers kept ticking up slowly, almost as if the fuel mixture was overly rich. But as soon as the engine reached 5,000 RPM, the tachometer needle jumped fiercely upward and the boost gauge shot to 2.0 km/h.
とピーキーだな。おいしいところは5000から8000の間かな。
In a car like this, you wanted to keep the clutch on even the tightest corner. But given how lightweight it was, if you happen to bump into something while turning to the curb, God only knows where you end up landing. At the same time, she had to make sure not to decelerate or let the RPM needle fall too much. On the uphill curves in particular, there'd be a real danger of the engine stalling if her entry was anything less than perfect.
これ、結構やばい車かも。
ほーら、チルチル、車に乗るのよ。
骨の横にはもう絶対乗らないって決めたの。別に私じゃなくてもいいでしょ。マキナ、本当か行きなさいよ。
そうは言っても、タナトスさんの指示は松島みちるって言ってたのよ。だからチルチルが行かなきゃダメなのよ。
なんで私を指定したのよ。
知らん。
みちる様、あまりわがままをおっしゃらないでください。後で好きなお菓子買ってあげますから。
子供じゃあるまいし、そんな言葉に騙されないわよ。
いらないんですか、お菓子。
何買ってくれるのよ。
何でもいいですよ。一つだけなら何でも好きなの買ってあげます。
どうでもいいけど早くしてくれる？時間ないんだけど。
わかったわよ、乗ればいいんでしょ、乗れば。
というわけで、ミチル様の快諾が得られたところで、よろしくお願いします、アマネさん。
With such an end of Thanatos 4, currently display analog stopwatch, the time the remain will display in the separate counter on the bottom of the screen. Only probably getting into one counter's cup holder.
じゃあ、行ってくる。ごめんね。人乗せると重くなっちゃうから。とりあえず、ミチルだけ連れてく。
Okay, we're gonna get a CG40, I believe.
アマネー、気をつけるのよ。
わかってる。
ノリとマキナ、アマネーリチャー、started the stop.
タイマーがゼロになったらスタートするよ。ほら、ちゃんとベルトした？
ちょ、アマネ、私まだ、お腹の具合が。
いい加減、もう全部吐いちゃったでしょ。時間がないのよ。最初はゆっくり行くから我慢して。
Going to short shifter to put the car in first gear, Amani glanced behind her, then eased her car around roads towards the main road outside the lot. Flipping on her turn signal, she hit the brake on the slanting sidewalk ramp and keeping the car in a sprinter style, leaning hot hold shot stance, pushed the engine up toward 5,000 RPM. On the verge of reaching the power band, she paused to double check the area around.
後方よし、前方よし、もう一度後方よし、行くよ、ミチル。
ゆっくり行くんでしょ。ゆっくり行くって言ったよね。
私とミチルでゆっくりの解釈が少し違うかもしれないね。5 4 3 2。
やっぱ降りる。フルーステ
ノ、
もう遅いってのは。ゼロ。
Yeah, let's go. The very Star Wars finish countdown, I'm gonna roughly engage the clutchThe compact cross-transmission let out a distinctive high-pitched whine. In less than 3 seconds, she burned right through first gear. As she lines the accelerator pedals and stepped on the clutch, exhausted from the turbines escaped audibly through the wastegate. Quickly moving the shift knob, She stepped down on the accelerator once again, and in no time at all, she blew through second gear as well. The racing cross transmission like this one, the gap to third gear was wide, but fourth and fifth would come easily afterwards. And even when changing gears, the engine kept moving at 77,500 RPM, allowing for steady acceleration.
Oh, 軽いせいかな。なんかポコポコ跳ねちゃうけど、いいぞ、いける。
うらせ、私は行きたい。
Rushed down the road carrying two Polish young women in a very state of mind. Tanato had instructed them to bring Tsushima Michiru to the designated point within the allocated time. Letting her out clearly wasn't an option. As the city streets drew past outside her window, all she could do was wear in distress, avoiding traffic lights of the first woman and stare down through a series of back roads. Eventually reaching the foot of the mountain that made it look across, there she stopped the car and got out at the examine. As soon as the vehicle came to a halt, Michiru tumbled out and grabbed her mouth and began to retch once more. By now, she fully expected the contents of her stomach, so only as it came out of her throat. Watching her unfortunate friend out there, out from her eyes, Amanda spot down next to the car and checked the condition of his tires. As tires like this were designed for racing, but they had a nasty tendency to lose their grip entirely when they got worn out.
Okay, the tire is still alive. It's in a good mood. It's dry. Okay, it's good. It's good.
私の胃もドロドロだわよ。もう着いたの。
何言ってんの？ここからが本番じゃない。
嘘でしょ。もう無理。吐いても何も出ないわよ。
大丈夫。吐くだけ吐いて、辛いのを通り越したら、今度はだんだん気持ちよくなってくるから。
それってさ、脳が、これ以上はやばいって判断してんじゃないの？
ここからなら、あと30分もかからないから、すぐに終わるって。ほら乗って、
シルが？
車が！
Had this girl built out of her own brain fluid somehow, for me to say she clearly needed to finish this as quickly as possible. Before moving into Silas, while Amani flipped the intercooler spray switch, hoping to lower its temperature somewhat.Generally speaking, you always wanted to keep your bedroom warm and your motor as cool as possible. Bursts of cooling help keep air flowing to your engine stations, allowing for a greater concentration of oxygen in the air through which they're regaining you some of the power you lost during the heat. That said, engines tend to return to their normal temperature within a few minutes of being cooled, so this sort of procedure was only marginally useful. Normally, I always thought the accelerator felt a bit more responsive for a while afterwards, so it wasn't something she could totally dismiss.After one quick final check of the car's condition, she glanced at her watch 33 minutes left. Even for Amari, getting past this mountain in that amount of time wasn't going to be easy.
というわけで、ここからは本気で行くよ。
本気って、今までのは何だったの？
今までっていうか、私、隣に人を乗せて本気で走るのはこれが初めてだよ。
大丈夫。なの？
信じてもらうしかないかな。まあ、ホームコースだし、大丈夫でしょ。
Before Anna came to Miyama, when she was helping out her family with their business, she always took this exact road over the mountain to pick up eggs for a poultry farm on the other side. Then her best driver then started into it was 37 minutes and 32 seconds. Based on that, they just were going to make it. But even so, the only wins of this car, she was definitely going to make it somehow. The S4 has been designed for the girl to compete in a rally race on the public road, and for some time after its debut, nothing could compare to its power. Amani had the greatest possible confidence in it. Although it didn't weigh any more than the average mini truck, it was packing an engine with some genuine horsepower. And unlike the 8-pound tire you find on an average mini truck, it was equipped with a road leader as tires ideal for high-speed maneuvering. Firmly fastening her 4-point tires and pressing her hips against the back of her seat, only switched her tire to time attack mode.
3, 2, 1, 0, start!
Synchronizing with the countdown of her attack meter, the force sitting on the dashboard, she waited for the second hand to hit 0 to begin the race. The sudden burst of power sent it shooting forward, stopping her escape to either side, making the S4 frame tremble and groan.As the car accelerated explosively, its force surely tracked high performance tire force at the road surface. And when she turned the steering, Amanda sensed through her seat and that its weight had shifted onto the outer rear tire. Just from the way the car moved, she could tell the exact condition of every tire.
いいぞ、加速が戻ってる。いっけー、クロスコー。
In fact, their brain was melting, but not in a bad way. Most of all, my acceleration was something like that, not a plastic. As a baby, she sat on her father's knee and revealed in the speed of his car. Her father might associate the sound and engine with the comfort of her mother's womb. The faster she went, the closer she felt. It was an ecstatic and utterly soothing feeling. I'm gonna spend a good deal of time behind the wheel of a front heavy mini truck with a painfully short wheel base and for very and very little in the way of power. But if nothing else, cooking with its floppy, chassis, and unforgiving handling had taught her how to precisely control the distribution of weight across the tires. And of course, she drew in the slope countless times. Under all possible conditions, she knew every curve and foot like the back of her hand. When you throw in a genuinely power maneuvering car like this, it was almost unfair to everyone else on the street.
いいぞ、ぐいぐい登る。やっぱターボってすごいな。足もしっとりしててよく動く。無駄に硬いだけの足より姿勢が作りやすい。
The key to success lay in this early uphill session where her technical skills could gain her a few precious seconds time. Here and there, it was actually designed her total time. The second half was downhill with a lot of straightaways.The power that her car would be only relevant factor. She had to get as much time as she possibly could before then. Tied the battery to a sharp right side at the top of the third gear, she threw the car into fourth while approaching the first checkpoint. The small car that slowed down in good form happened. She got it through the first session more than 40 seconds ahead of her best mini truck time. The next problem was the small jumping spot just like the bridge over the real Goku River. If you were going too fast when you hit that point, all four of your wheels would leave the road and you end up losing speed. Better to ease out on the trolley.Set. Apart from hairpin turns, she did allow her tires to slide around. No reason to let any power escape to slide when it could be pushing her forward instead. By the next checkpoint, vending machine by the rock of the liquid stock, she gained another 2.5 seconds. A very nice pace. She could do this! But just as somebody was staring at the prospect of entering, the tail of another car appeared a little way in front of her. Uh-oh.
せやから、パーティー行かなあかんねんやんか。
The vehicle in question was in vogue by all accounts, the single powerful super sports car in the world. As for the man driving this intentionally famous car for the purpose of this episode, let us give him the name of Big Nose. God only knows what exactly he seemed to do for a living. So he routinely purchased the most powerful car he possibly could without better in a desire to arrive at his friend's parties as quickly as humanly possible. The only reason he got his hand on the car like couldn't be expected possibly was fairly good. That's why he'd be on the cloud.
Yeah, なんやろな。これ乗っとるとマッキネンが来ても負ける気せえへんわ。やっぱ最強の車の条件言うんは価格と馬力と運転のしやすさやんな。
In short, I'll take this divine gift. The big nose man was totally drunk on his power. Oh, that's how it is. But just a moment ago, he noticed a small family car on the road behind him. Although he was trying not to use too much gasoline or wear out the side, he meant they were still moving at a very decent speed.So when he glanced in the first neighbor and saw the unnecessary vehicle, it was understandably downfall.
Uso やろ? どっから出てきてん、あの車? つか、なんで追いついてこれんねん、きしょいわ。よっしゃ! ほな、バイロン様の本気いうやつをちょいと見せつけたろかいな。
Uh-oh, this will trigger Amane to boost up the speed later. On even the briefest of straightaways, all you have to do was press down the accelerator and the Bayron will accelerate as much as you want.On Japan's narrow highway, however, you could have kicked the escalator all the way down for a single single. This corner would be right in front of you in the flip of an eye. This was an ungodly and spicy car, and their power in proportion of his car, break nose complete was absolute. He glanced at his mirror.Only to find that the distance between the eye actually shrunk, he could feel the hairs on the back of his neck standing up.
嘘やん、なんでやねん。つかあれ何、あんなお前、親戚の姉ちゃんが駅まで送ってったろか、言う時に乗る車やっけ。
But for some reason, every time he went around the corner, it was getting closer and closer. How could a green mobile car like that chase it out of a bike? It didn't make the single damn sense.
ずっと言えばカー、カーと言えばバイロンやぞ、なんでやねん。
Reality was bending down, standing down on him, but it was difficult for Big Nose to accept. When he touched the brake pedal, approached the enduring grill face of the S4 grew larger and larger in his rearview mirror. His driver was taking advantage of the car's low weight to hit the brake much later than more than compensated for their difference in horsepower. Big Nose had conquered one crucial advantage that any motor vehicles could possess, the nimbleness of a featherweight.
嘘や。バイロンやねんぞ。
By smuggling and assuming that space technological rendering invisible may have infected his own doom. To Big Nose, the dark green vehicle in his rear revealer was no longer just a car. It was a Mitsubishi AA-64 fighter plane on the tail of his F4U Corsair. Enemy couldn't shake out no matter how he squirmed.
Ale wa Zero ya. Zero wa mada ikitotta ya.
Zero was riding his ass. For Big Nose, who grown up is hearing his American grandfather sorry about his death as a fighter pilot, the thought was enough to fill him with absolute terror. A trigger of force that ran out his fight in combination with the psychological pressure very down on him, exploring his reaction with time slightly. Midnight's corner approaching far too quickly, moving on his slide on his brain, defended by brain beneath his feet as they literally ABS activate. When he finally moved his steering wheel, the final obligatory turn is not inward, but it was already too late. In the very next instant, the dark visitor had pushed his goofy little snow into a slightly guy, he left on his dead inside of the curve. Just as he was there, Big Nose here, Rafa is on the race stage and the driver changed gear. The sun was very, very close. Oh no, they're right next to me. They're right next to me when I collapsed. The man only just changed his bearing. And given his unusual body, Big Nose didn't have precise sense of how much space there was between the two vehicles. The fear of the high speed collision left his hand frozen on the wheel. Once again, he was forced to stand down on the brake, this time even harder than before, the battery speed on it dropped dramatically. In a flash of an eye, the dark green slid rushly past him. He passed him a murderous creature at lunge, hit by an awful smile on his face after swinging blood in at his throat. His wind of fire had broken, Big Nose sat like a statue in his bloodshed state. Every moment he managed to swallow. The adrenaline had drained from his body and shivers were running down his spine. His foot eased off the accelerator. Slowly and quietly, he pulled over his shoulders. As his hands left the steering wheel, he realized they were trembling. It felt as if he just awoke from a terrible nightmare. But he knew the truth, that devilish thing, the dark green Zero, was all too real. He met a monster and survived. His mind was full of boredom, relief, and terror. Wrapping his arm tightly around his leather steering wheel, Big Nose leaned forward and quickly weep. And we have arrived. Master Shima Michiru still fastened tightly to the Zero's passenger seat. I spent the entire ride and started vaguely into a space where a special of someone trying to force his knees. By the time she regained consciousness, the car has already come to a stop.
Suita no.
What an adventure you have!
地図で指示された場所って大体この辺だと思うんだけど。
Look at what Jamani found and made it within a 50 seconds to spare. Let's say they were currently sitting in the middle of the farm road, surrounded by fields, the only human being in the sight of a voice of farmer who seems to be taking a screw with a cow.
きっと、あの牛連れたおばちゃんが次のヒントくれるのよ。
え？そんなまさか。
ちょっと聞いてくる。もう、ちょっと、ミチル！
Ignore Yamani's attempt to stop. Michiru leaps out of the car and ran over to the old woman.
つか、なんて声かける気よ。
松島ミチルです。ヒントをください。松島ミチルです。
へえ、そのままかーい。
Smacking the steering wheel with a bell hand. I wanted to replace it from the obvious thought. Naturally, not the old lady with the car was ready to take a back bite for a sweat.
Angayo, wakanen dake chomo yo. Dare ga do majigatten de ne no ge? Are? Chiga!
Doi koto? Ome, are ga atomo no byouki ga?
Aiya, Shaeba yama no mukou ni sanatorium chuu no ga ande. Soko itte soudan shire?まあ、キャミの毛、こんな色さなるまでバカになってしもって。お気の毒なこと。
違います。松島バカじゃありません。松島は。
Did she really look at that down in the glass? Was it her hair? Her speech was understated, finally ready to abandon the bottom line of way of life. Suddenly, the old woman closed the gate to emulate the endless running jingle.
Oh, 電話だな。ちょっくら、ごめんなんしょ。
Reaching into a brass pocket, the car lady took out a smartphone and stylish apple on the back.
おいよ、なじょした？
Link at the screen with more force than with it was. She pressed the phone to hear.After a brief conversation to which the old lady contributed only a few glances, she turned back to stare at Michiru with a slightly dubious look in her eyes.
Oh, 確かに小汚い黄色いのけど。はあ、こいつのことかの。
うん、お嬢ちゃん、名前なんて言うかがの。
松島です。松島みちるです。
ほんじゃったらおめに電話が。
みちるグレイブローでオーレディスポート AS I suspected the voice of the area is live below to Thanatos。
おいっす、タナトスジャケットもよ。
お、こんなとこに呼び出してどういうことよ。何もないじゃない。
まあ、あなたたちの機動力をテストしただけだから、目的地なんてどこでもよかったのよ。次で最後だから頑張りなさいな。いい？今から言うことを暗記して。
あ、うん。
次の指令は現在位置から東へ30キロの方向に東海線の東松浜駅があるから、そこに向かいなさい。
そんなことを言うだけのためにこんなところに呼び出したの？そんなの電話かければすぐに済む用事じゃない。なんでわざわざこんな場所に呼び出して牛のおばちゃんの電話を使うの？おかげでちょっと恥かいたじゃないのよ。恥かいた。
だって電話だけ指定場所に送るという方法を取られたらテストの意味がないでしょ。だから現地の回線であなたの存在を確認するためにこうしたのよ。まあ電話だけを40キロ離れた場所に送ったとしても、それはそれで評価すべき手腕だとは思うけれど、今回はダメ。わかる？
わかんにゃい。
よし、それでいい。わからないときは私の言葉だけを信じなさい。いいわね、松島みちる。
あお
あうじゃないわよ。はいかいいえかはっきりしないのがあなたの悪い癖よ。
はいはいはいはい、わかったわよ。ちゃんと言う通りにすればいいんでしょ。
はい、いい子ね。じゃあ牛のおばさまにお礼を言って次の行動に移りなさい、この豚。
この豚。
あ、今豚って言った？
言ってないわよ。
ああ、そう、空耳ならいいんだけど。
急ぎなさい、豚。
あれ、やっぱ豚って言ってるよね。
小汚い黄色い豚。
おやおや、はっきりと言っちゃってるよね。
And Michiru saw a ridge vanish under the peaceful fields and clear blue sky above them. Thank you, cow lady. Oh, they arrived! Wow! People gather in many places. The dentist's office on Friday, the beach in summer, but the station is always a particularly popular choice. About 1 hour after receiving her new orders, Michiru arrived at the station she's been directed to and found it overflow with
friends. Hi, 到着! お疲れ!
何を? 何を運転しようと思えばできるんじゃない?
刀を持っているからといって、いつも抜刀して歩いてる侍はいないでしょ。同じ。
何よそれ。
すぐに刃物を抜くやつはただのチンピラだって話。それより駅に着いたら何しろって？
知らないわよ。とにかく駅に行けって言われた時だし。
何よそれ。
だから知らないわよ。私に聞かないでくれる？
ほらみちる、電話。
分かってるわよ。はい、もしもし。
Music! Where's the music? Okay, let's go.
あら、なんだか私に対する不満がありそうなテンションね。元気を出していきましょうよ。それこそダンスでも踊る勢いで。
はあ？あんたのせいでしょうがよ！豚って言った！私のこと豚って言った！
口を開けば何かとブーブー文句を言ってうるさいからよ。
謝りなさいよ。謝れ。
そうね、ごめんなさい、豚さん。
豚の方に謝った。
まあそろそろ鬱陶しいから無視して話を進めるけれど、ここからはあなた一人で行動しなさい。ところで松島みちる、あなたダンスは得意？
Wait, did I miss anything?Oh, okay.
ダンス？
そう、例えばワルツとか。
そんなの踊ったことないわよ。
そう、じゃあ教えてあげる。まずは携帯電話のコンパスの画面を見て。西に247度。
え？270？247
度よ。 20メートル先に売店が見えるでしょ。
あ、うん。
次に床を見て。タイルの目地に沿ってまっすぐに11歩進む。
11歩。
焦らないでいいわ。いつものペースで歩きなさい。ただし11歩以上歩いてはダメよ。
1歩2歩3歩。
いちいち声に出さないでいいから、頭の中で数えなさい。それと指を折って数えるのも禁止。
むずい。
松島さん、今何時？
え？あ、11時36分。
ありがとう。ところで、今何歩目？
わあ、忘れた！
7歩目よ。本当におバカね、あなた。
さいな！あんたがごちゃごちゃ言うからでしょうが！
いいから歩きなさい。あと4歩。
7、8、9、10、11。
だから声に出すなと。
あれ？私また喋ってた？
まあいいわ。あと半歩進んで。あなた、おバカな上に短足ね。
ああ、なんなのよ、もう。
次は、北に340度。4歩進んで、一旦止まって。
ちゃんと説明しなさいよ！私今何やらされてるの？
いいから言う通りに。
はいはいはいはい。1歩、2歩、3歩、4歩。これでいい？
ちゃんと歩幅を守りなさいな。あなた、少し大股で歩いたわね。薄汚い金髪がカメラに見切れてるわ。
カメラ？
その場で顔を右に向けてみなさい。天井に半球状のものがついているでしょ？それがカメラよ。あなたにはそれらに映らないように移動してもらっているの。
何のために？え？なんで映っちゃダメなの？
国に対して牙を向こうという人間がのんきにライブカメラに間抜け面さらすわけにはいかないのよ。日本中に設置されたライブカメラは私の目です。私の目に触れるということは政府の目に触れるということなの。記録が残れば物的証拠にもなります。お分かり？
全然わかんにゃい。
それでよし。とにかく私の指示通りに動きなさい。
あ、船、売店でイカの塩辛売ってる。
買いに行くな。というか私の話を聞いて。お願いだから。
你们想要的是在 grow your usage of various social network and was now increasingly accepted as part of the Japanese language. Naturally, Tanaka was familiar with the terms and his concepts were basic. Given that there were fixed rules and behavior by the involved, she assumed that such a rule would be quite easy to deal with. By this point, she was aware of how wrong she'd been. In practice, the student was an aggravatingly unimaginable creature, and it didn't help that Masashima Michiru was personally prone to sudden and dramatic mood swings.On the whole, this was well more than she bargained for. Somewhat related, Thanatos was beginning to realize that referring to someone as a tsundere was really just a roundabout way of calling them a royal pain in the ass. In the face of a problem so daunting that fast, after fast of the calculation, simulation ended in failure, sometimes even an ultra advanced supercomputer simply had to sign. Of course, his signing in exasperation was a quintessentially.
振り幅の不安定は回数をこなすことで学習するしかないわね。面白いわ。
Display emotions. Some even consider that proof of Thanatos' profession.
はい。
次は南西240度へ3歩。
ああ、はいはい。南西240度へ3歩ね。1、2、3。
はい、そこで止まって。
ここで？
あ、失礼。
急に立ち止まるから後ろの人に追突されるのよ。立ち止。
ああ、だって止まれって言ったじゃん。
なんだかあなた、私が気を利かせて背後を確認しながら止まりなさいと言ったら、今度は前から来た人とぶつかりそう。
そこまでバカじゃないし。
Hey, could you tell me the way?
あの、
外国人観光客に道聞かれてるんじゃないわよ。そんな頭してるから声かけられるんでしょ。
なんて答えればいいの？
あなたの心臓はアメリカに住んでいたって設定なんだから英語ぐらい話せるでしょ。
設定っていうな。実際住んでたわよ。
だったらさっさと頭を切り替えて答えなさいな。
わかってるわよ。I'm sorry! I don't know this area very well.
Okay. Thank you.
何そのチレつかつ貧しい英語力。
うるさいな！アメリカ在住って言ったって、日本人街に住んでりゃこんなもんなのよ！
という設定。
設定言うな！
まあいいわ。一応会話は成立するようだし、使い道もあるでしょう。
なんか全然納得いかないんですけど。
説得する気もないし、納得する必要もありません。右を見て。
あ、右？
バカが見る。
もう帰ってもいい？
冗談よ。一応右と左の区別はつくようね。
私そこまでバカの子だと思われてる？
そこから右にコインロッカーが見えるでしょ？
見える。
そこへ行ってちょうだい。当然コインロッカーにも監視用のカメラが設置されているけれど、今そこのカメラにはダミーの映像をループさせてあるから無視していいわ。
何よ！だったら最初から全部そうすればよかったじゃない！大した用もないのに駅の中をぐるぐるぐるぐる歩かせて、最初からすぐにここに案内しなさいよ！
ありものの映像を切りのいいところでつなぎ合わせただけのショートループ映像だから、あまり長時間は騙せないのよ。いいからさっさと行ってロッカーを開けなさい。
開けるって、鍵は？
ポケットの中。
え？
フィッシュ立てるドアポケミチュファイアンフェミリティウィリネ。
いつの間に？
さっき人とぶつかったでしょ？あの時よ。携帯電話を渡した時もそうだったけれど、メンバーの中ではあなたが一番好きだらけでネタを仕込みやすいのよね。あなたって子供の頃学校で背中にバカって書いた紙を貼られていじめられたことない？
Oh no wonder she get that phone.
ないわよ！
そう？なんだかあなたって学生服の背中に友達の上履きの足跡とかつけたまま。
But still don't understand how she get that phone. Maybe it's Yuji's phone, but we don't know.
クスクス笑われながら授業を受けてたかわいそうな子ってイメージなんだけれど。
的確に言い当ててんじゃないわよ！あんたエスパー！
いいからロッカーを開けなさい。
わかったわよ、まったく。
All she had to do was check the tag number to her key and lock it. The locker mark with the same number. Maybe the task is simple. You couldn't help feeling it because when Mitchell met Tsushima, Mitchell was involved. If a woman like this were to graduate from school and get a job at the locker park, everyone who knew her would be sweating buckets every time they flip a light switch. She might have some attention as an energy conservation tool.
Locker は見つかった？
あった。
Push the key to the locker key or she gave it to her body the needle door.
これってどういう意味？
All to print it to me, the lady which is in the hair with a magnificent tongue, crossing her neck to bend in highly unnatural fashion.
すみません。
Why you turn around, Michiru? What a dummy you are. Clutch your hand. Michiru clutched to the ground and began to convulse like a fish tossing out on the shore.
だから振り返るなと書いてあったでしょうに。それなのにどうして振り返るのかしら。私はあまり詳しくないのだけれど、それがツンデレというものなの？まあ、そういうものだと理解しておけば、それはそれで制御も可能か。ちょっと、私の話を聞いている？もしかして、死んじゃった？
死んでないわよ！
あら、よかった。だったらさっさと起き上がりなさいな。
あんたね、これはただのいじめよ！
でもおかげで、あなたのことがよくわかったわ。ひどいことをしてごめんなさい。とりあえず、ロッカーの中の紙を剥がしてちょうだい。 その紙の裏にテープでロッカーの鍵が貼り付けてあるでしょ。
あった。
それは隣のロッカーの鍵よ。開けてごらんなさい。大丈夫、もう何も仕掛けはないわ。そこがゴール。
嘘じゃないでしょうね。信用するからね。
わー、That's the same point! Second locker slowly appeared from the unexpected sentry profile. I don't like a check in the box, but standard size problem, there was no chance that I only forced cell phone.
電話？
そう、電話。その携帯電話なら、タナトスシステムのシギントに触れないわ。
シギントって何？
簡単に言えば、通信傍受による諜報活動網のことよ。あなたたちが日頃意識せずに使っている携帯電話の会話やメールの内容は、すべてタナトスシステムによって監視されています。
So this four phones is a special one.
ああ、それ、なんかユミコから説明された気がする。っていうか、本当にそんなことってできるの？
できるわよ。簡単に言ってしまえば、政府のワードノートに記載された言葉や文字に反応して記録しているの。例えば、次元爆弾の作り方なんてワードで検索エンジンを使ったりすれば、検索した本人も気づかないうちにかなりの高確率でトラップの網にかかって記録されるわ。他にも、銀行強盗なんて言葉を電話で口にすれば、即座に発信者と受信者を特定して記録、会話の内容の危険度が検討されるというわけ。
すごいじゃない！それってすごいじゃない！
まあ、でも、そんな網にかかるのは雑魚ばかりで、本当に狡猾な人たちは当然のごとくリンゴとか暗号で会話をするから、大きな成果は出ないのだけれど、とにかくその電話を使えば足がつかないから、今後の電話連絡はそれを使うように。
え、ただでもらっていいの？
ええ、もちろん。電話機本体0円、通話料もパケット料も無料だから、ガンガン話せるし、じゃんじゃんメールも打てるわよ。
やったー！
ただし、あなたたち5人による相互通話はできるけれど、他の電話にかけることはできないわよ。
何よそれ、もう意味なくない？
いいじゃない、どうせ他にかける相手もいないでしょ。
確かにそうですけど。
She was perfectly aware she didn't have any friends, but when someone went out of their way to point it out, it still offended her. Yes, I also don't have any friends.
セーブするか。
And the episode here, Blue Wars Time. Adios, Famosa.